I really appreciate the confidence that you have shown in me. That is why I'm here again. Please accept my heartfelt gratitude. Good morning, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests. My dad always said, you are known by your actions. And he ensured, whatever I will say, I will surely fulfill. My name is Sumit Malik. I hope you must have remembered my ice-breaking speech when I shared my dream of financial planning and financial freedom. Today we will jointly learn about financial freedom and steps of financial planning. One goal that we all have in common is that we all want to make more money. Financial freedom is much more than having money. It's the freedom to be who you really are and do what you really want in your life. However, a small percentage of us actually achieve the financial freedom we long for. Financial freedom is available to those who learn it and work on it. One good news is that there are more people achieving financial freedom faster today than ever before through proper financial planning and making it a goal to improve their personal finances. You can become one of them too. Every one of us is talented, but not everyone identifies his or her abilities. Financial freedom is a mental, emotional, and educational process. Today, I am not going to teach you how to create wealth, but to tell you the mindset required to achieve the financial freedom. Begin to think positive about money. Thinking negatively about money is an obstacle that you must eliminate in order to achieve financial freedom. You must eliminate the thought that having more money may lead to evil or money cannot buy you the happiness. Friends, money cannot think and decide to make anyone good or evil. But people actions do, and you are known by your actions. The truth is that money is essential to happiness. Material property predicts life satisfaction. And the more economic freedom we achieve, the more we will feel satisfied about our life. The best thing money can buy is financial freedom. For financial freedom, there are some financial planning steps. Number one, talk to your spouse. Most couples never talk to each other about their financial goals. I was also one of them. Through this journey to learn financial freedom, I studied almost 20 articles and concluded this point on the top. If you want something that you never have had, then you have to do something that you have never done. The goal here is not to think alike, but to think together. Point number two, figure out where you are right now. Before you start worrying about where you want to go, you first have to figure out where you are right now. Determine your net worth. List all the values of your assets and all the values of your liabilities. Subtract liabilities from your assets. Then you will discover your true net worth. Friends, if you do this, after 1 year, you will surely feel happy that you have started today. Number three, track your incomes and incomes and spendings. The key to building a strong financial plan is to understand how much you spend and save right now. The part most people dread is taking a really close look at their expenses. Beware of little expenses. A small leak may sink a great ship. Point number four, set your life goals. Financial goals do not just happen. You make them happen. This step requires you to assess where you want to be after 5, 10 or 20 years from now. And asking some big questions. Where you want to live after your retirement. And when you stop working. The point here is, a goal without plan is just a wish. Number five, create an investment policy. Every financial plan, professional financial plan, includes an investment policy statement, IPS, that recommends how a portfolio should be invested. It puts in writing the rules that make sure you are a disciplined investor. and IPS helps you to stick with your plan and keep you abreast with the changing course when the market gets volatile. The key to making money in stocks is not to get scared out of them, but be hellish sure. Right? But be hellish sure. Every one of us is scared and every one of us is feared from failure. If your intuition says you are on the right path, then take first step, then another, and another. You do not need magic to transform your world. Financial freedom is freedom from failure. And in the end, I would like to say, I am not born just to pay bills and die. I am a master of my life, a life of financial freedom, a life of my own. And I look forward to add good experiences and values to the club. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.